Hey there, so before we get into the video, there were just a few things that I just wanted to bring up. So first of all, you may notice in the video that the recording is cut short, or it started off suddenly. I did not do this on purpose, it just kind of happened that way. I just messed up the timing of the recording, and some of it got cut short, like I was in the middle of something when it starts, but the main point of the video is still there. You can still get everything you need from the video, it shouldn't be too much of an issue. I just wanted to bring it up, because in the video, I'm talking as if I'm going to keep showing you stuff, and then it just stops. So I just wanted to give a heads up about that. But yeah, other than that, everything else went well with the video, and I hope you find it helpful or enjoyable. Also, one more thing. I will do my best to re-record the parts that I missed, so that it is complete, and you can just watch me do that part and see what I did to get through and everything like that. So yeah, that should be all good. Alright, enjoy. I didn't really talk all that much. There wasn't that much commentary. I mean, I did commentate, but only every so often, and I'm just trying to make it a bit better quality, I guess. I'm not trying to ramble either. So yeah, you just watched me clear the first few rooms. You know, it's pretty straightforward. You know, I had some loot in here. These, be careful with these. If you hit these, they'll do that. Yeah, I found out the hard way the first time. Also, if you're going to throw them, make sure you're far enough away from the impact, because you will take immediate damage. It's a rather large explosion. It's like throwing one of those red cans of oil. And this here is a secret room. Nice little hidden mechanism. There's this up here, you can get money in that, I think, but you can also get potions. I just got a potion of speed from it. I think I'm full, so let me get rid of something so I can open this. I get rid of this. Another Crusader's Remorse, I'm gonna get rid of that. I just don't have the room for that right now. I also don't have the room for these, I'm full on them. Okay. Yeah, so there's a portal right there as soon as you open that door. I think it comes with like 3 to 5 enemies. Thank you. Okay. Got a torture somewhere. I can hear him. So yeah, it does get more and more cryptic as you go deeper, but it will be easy enough to figure out once you get a feel for it. Like sometimes they throw you a whammy by putting the shrine that you need to activate on a different floor than the door. Or sometimes you'll get a random enemy to spawn like that. I don't know what triggers the respawn, or if it's random. But sometimes I can't catch the pattern, so I'm not sure if I can tell you about that. Ooh, lovely. Oh. Okay. There's any lootables in here. And this room only has like two enemies. Which is nice. It's a little bit of a break in between. You don't have to rush as much. It's a gut spiller. I think that's always there, but I haven't seen it be anything but gray yet. Huh. Maybe I got that one already, I don't know. Yeah, let's get rid of these rusty ships. Alright, here is, I think, our first portal. You unlock the portals. You won't get the portals on your first playthrough in Hellraid, because it's getting into Lucius's study and everything. The portals you unlock on your second time after the portal appears in Lucius's study to replay Hellraid. That's when I got it to pop up. I don't know if there was another special condition or not, but hopefully that helps. I must be full again. Oh, my gut spill that I don't want. A ruffian sword that I don't want. Sorry, I know. I am pickier than most about the color of my weapons. There's a good reason for that, though. Okay. I don't think there's anything else in there. There might be some secrets, but it looks pretty inaccessible to me. And then I don't see anything up there. There might be a stone or something up there as a consumable, but I don't know. I suppose I could look while I'm here. I can't reach it. I mean, I might be able to. If I jump from my starting point. Not what I meant to do. Okay, so can get up there, yeah. There's a stone up here. It's a blue crystal. There's a healing potion over here. I don't see anything over there. So yeah, I guess it's a good thing that I showed that. Or that I checked, rather, before I gave my final answer on it. Alright, so this is like an arena area. You should get yourself ready before you go and activate the shrine, because that's when it is going to get very real. Lightning Spot has a pretty high durability for a sword. I actually think I want to use one of these battle mallets though, because I know I'm going to keep getting them, and they'd be really useful right about now. And you'll see why in just a minute. I don't think there's very many lootables in here. I don't really see anything, to be honest. Okay. Troublesome guys, honestly, are the ones that have elemental effects that throw fireballs at you, amongst other things. Because when you use a potion of resistance, it's not effective against the fire. You will still take just as much damage. If you're taking that damage on top of whatever physical damage you're getting, even with the resistance potion, it's kind of like, your best bet would probably be to give him the runaround to the best of your ability. Go take care of the guys that are getting you from afar, because it's going to leave you more breathing room to take care of the ones that are chasing you. Okay. If you ever don't know where to go, just look for that icon right in front of where my character arrow is, up in the top right corner. It's got like a little doorway with a unlocked symbol in it. That's to show that you've unlocked the next area, and that's where you go. This room does have some consumables in it, for a fact. Okay, it's not on this side. It's on one of these sides. There's a chest here. Nothing there. Let's check out the other side. There's a yellow crystal by the looks of it. I can't remember. Oh, it's a white one, sorry. I can't remember what all of them do off the top of my head. I do apologize about that. If I get the opportunity to edit it in, like in text or something, I will, but I'm not entirely sure if I will, but get ready to have some serious combat. Stay on top here. Take respect. you're having trouble with the shield guy, I will give a tip on that in just a minute. I'm gonna try to see. Anything from the front, and he will counter. He does have a two-handed weapon that he wields with one hand, so the heavy, it is a heavy hit. Don't let it fool you just because he's only using one hand. So look to the side and sort of dodge to get behind him. It's the best way to get a hit, or wait until he swings. Alright, so this is the third kind of roam area. I don't know it as well as I know the last one, but give it a quick look around to see if there's any consumables or anything. I didn't see any up there, but I did go kind of quick, so I apologize if I fell. Sorry. And I'm just all over the place. Alright, so there's a chest over here with healing potion and stamina potion. Great Crusader's remorse. Alright, I'm not seeing too much else. Nothing up here. Just glad it wasn't. I know, I'm acting foolish. I'm just trying to get up there to see if there's anything up there. Oh. It's just, okay. I don't see anything up here, so I guess that answers my question. Alright, I'm gonna have to switch back from the mallet, but I might just use the sword for a moment here instead. This one, I have a bit more trouble with than the others. 100%. No lie. Yeah, I'm almost dead. It's a miracle that I'm still breathing. Just gotta give him the run around and heal up to the best of your ability. Also, you can't activate a medkit while one is still used. It's just not gonna activate until that medkit is fully used up. Well, actually, it's not true. It activates, but it's not going to be in effect until the last one. It's done. So the bar will be going down as you fight or whatever. Whatever. I'll just give you an example. So you can see that I'm like over halfway through my med kit. I'll activate another one now. It's not popping up that it's active, but wait until the bar goes all the way down. See what I mean? Yeah, you should have seen exactly this. They do a lot. Not fun fight. Alright, so that's that. Finally. At least I hope so. So we move through here. Got a blocked door. Treasure chest, Crusader's Remorse. Some other weapons that you apparently can't pick up. I wouldn't mind using some of them though. They look kind of nice. I like shorter blades for some reason. Not like dagger short, but short swords. This is the first key thing they gave you to unlocking whatever that is. First time around. Actually, I haven't really wanted to spoil what it is yet, but it's a guarded object. Alright, so let's just move on to the next. Okie dokie. Potion of healing up there. Healing potion. I don't know why I said potion of healing. Well, I suppose it's the same. That's why I said it. There's going to be a boss right behind the store, along with the crew runners and maybe some skeletons, but I guess this would be the last one. So I'll give you an example with these. Boom. So big that explosion was. I would have taken that. Alrighty. I think this is the first stone, but it might be the second. Alright. Somebody's angry. So be prepared. It's another torture. Go. this just for some loot. Explosive flask, acidic flask, foul blade, and a limb cutter. Oh, that was a chest I remember. I think that's it for this one. Does like 1,000 damage. All right, here's the next portal. Okie dokie. So this part is a little bit confusing, but you just need to follow what they've laid out. There's a blue crystal here. Let's get some more. You can go up this way. Here. Alright, so my idea is a little dangerous, but I want to push these guys off. So, I may not be able to. Yeah, I'm struggling enough to stay alive. This guy won't punch. I don't drop kicks, so. Alright, let's just get this done. Get going this way. So you can go left over here. Some chests, if you want what's in them. Alright, so the only path they've really laid out is this one. So this would be the way to go. I think you can go down this way, but I think that's for a bit later. I think they want you to go and complete this first, but I could be totally wrong. He fell. Alright, so we got our stuff. things worth. I guess I'll hold on to it for now. I have an extra slot. I think I want the Crusaders or Morris instead because I'm getting low on those. You can see how bad it is a time out there. We don't have to run yet, but there will be a section where you need to run from them, but I'm gonna actually try to use that section to knock them off the ledges, or throw them off the ledges, I think, as the game is working. I'm going through a lot of healing potions, man, I don't like it. So yeah, we're just all gonna start spawning my way. Not really possible to get one at first, right? Yep. My theory has been disproven. Can go up here though. If it wants to, and just knock him down. Yeah, but you might want to just drop him because. Don't even bother. Yeah, it looks like I got the bounty, but still. Just run. Fuck. I don't remember what I went to. Sorry about my language. Alright, maybe I have to go down. I don't know. I don't know, but I don't know. There you go. This is ridiculous. So yeah, that's how you get through that part. Obviously you could do it a bit better than I did, but yeah, that's it for the most part. Here's the second switch. So that bridge is over to that now. So I believe we only have one switch left. Means you have to go through one more portal. Thank you. This section's a bit different, but nothing to... Chosen one. If you guys want me to look at that, just let me know. I will collect them all and go over them all at some point. Obviously, I've already collected some, so I don't feel to show you where they were, but I might be able to do it another way, so we will see. Thunder Eel, that's what I unlocked with my last level up. Kill recruits, blunt weapons. Wish I activated that a bit sooner. No big deal though. Let's get the show on road. Want to get to that last portal. Foul blade. Switch. Yeah, sometimes there's weapons in there. Potion of endurance. I'm glad I got another one of those. Empty. Oh! Alright, I think I got everything in there. Let's just go. Also, if you ever lose where you're going, you usually have to go down. Okay, here's the third portal. Blue crystal right there in case you want it. Alright. That's okay. Oops, they give you a bunch of chests here. Can only mean they're preparing us, right? So, yeah, just be ready for something to happen, because this is a lot of items. So, I guess we just jump down and get started. But I am gonna get rid of that battle mallet and place the lightning swan in there. Yeah, we're just going right into it. I'm not even getting grace period. Come on. wings or if the door unlocked. Could be both. Yeah, we just unlocked a new area. Another Hellraid level up. Check that out in just a minute. Is the area we unlocked? I could be wrong. Might just be a big circle, I'm not sure. Just a big run around. Hopefully that was it. Yeah, it was. Alright, that was the third trial. So then you just gotta do this. And just watch it. Alright, now it's time to go find out if this is the same thing or not. Yeah, it's the fire wand. It's the same thing that I have equipped right now because I've already done this. But I was doing it for you guys and for the XP and stuff. Let's see if there's anything else that I unlocked. Yeah, it's the fire wand. And we also picked up a wand mastery. But I don't see it anywhere. Alright. So that's how you get the fire wand after you have already beaten the Hellraid once. If you need to see how to complete the Hellraid,